We're here in Shoalwater Bay, right on the front doorstep of Rockingham in Australia's southwest. This place is well underrated for the attractions it has to offer.
The waters here are relatively protected by rocky islands and perilous reefs. It's a boater's paradise, and if your expectations aren't too high, the fishing can be quite good. There's plenty of butterfish, no shortage of trumpeter, and blowies. The weeping toadfish, as it's also known, is a handsome creature that plays an important part in keeping our waters clean. They're considered a terrible nuisance by fishermen as dirty little bait gobblers.
Nothing like hooking onto a nasty big blowfish.
Some would say, when you're hooking onto the larger Norwest blowy, it's time to up anchor and move. There's also good numbers of skipjack trevally, plenty of whiting, and herring. Occasionally there is an unexpected surprise, such as this powerful Samson fish hitting live bait. And that's the last I see of him.
The main attraction is Penguin Island, 12.5 hectares of land about 500 metres from the shoreline near Rockingham. There is a ferry service, allowing people access to the island. A sandbar exists as an alternative crossing. A rising tide can bring currents that may be perilous for those attempting to cross. The island is so named because it's home to Western Australia's largest colony of little blue penguins. As they do not appear on the island until after dark, the best place to see them is at the Island Discovery Centre, located near the ferry landing. The little penguin is the world's smallest of the 17 species found only in the Southern Hemisphere. And they're the only ones to breed on mainland Australia. They lay their eggs in winter, so access to the island is restricted to daylight hours from mid-September to early June. These little characters spend their days fishing out at sea. Although capable of diving deep, they prefer to operate at depths between 5 to 20 meters while hunting schooling fish and tasty squid.
It's not just penguins that call this island home.
The islands in the area act as important rookeries for a large number of seabirds. The highly vocal and angry silver gull is one conspicuous resident. Other species include the brindled tern, the crested tern, the cormorant, and the pelican.
Amongst many other bird species are the pied oyster catcher and the welcome swallow.
Large numbers of feral pigeons inhabit the rocky terrain and fall prey to predators such as this peregrine falcon. Osprey are a far more reliable sighting, with several pairs nesting in the region.
Keep a sharp eye out for basking king skinks. To help protect the birds, visitors are requested to stick to the network of boardwalks that stretch across the island, avoiding the main roosting areas.
For the boatless visitor, options are available to get a more in-depth look at the attractions. There are kayak trips around the islands and tour boats focusing on the wildlife.
This chunk of rock and sand behind me is called Seal Island, and it's home to a colony of Australian sea lions. They're considered a rare species, but rarer still would be to show up here on any given day and not see one or two of these guys hanging out on shore.
Access to Seal Island is restricted to protect not just the animals, but people. These pinnipeds are equipped with a formidable set of teeth and no doubt can deliver a fearsome bite. This doesn't rule out the possibility of a chance encounter in the water, though.
Thank you.
A good portion of Shoalwater Bay is covered with seagrass, which is an important habitat for young fish and blue swimmer crabs. Gummy sharks are not so common here. In the warmer months, these shallow waters are visited by spotted eagle rays and their larger and more intimidating cousins, the giant stingray.
A steep bank drops from the shallows to around 20 metres deep where you can find the broken body of the Saxon Ranger. This 37 metre long vessel weighing 400 tonnes was built in England in 1960 where it worked the North Atlantic as a trawler. Later bought to work Australian waters, it became the first purpose-sunk wreck in the Perth metro area back in 2006. The deeper water holds big schools of yellow-tailed scad, said to be average eating with lots of bones, but accused of being one of the best live baits out there. Starfish cruise the sandy floor, drawn in by a burly bucket.
Scattered about the islands are numerous rocky reefs covered in large brown algae, such as kelp and sargassum. This provides an important habitat for fish, sharks, and rays. It also provides protection to schools of bait fish, such as hardyheads.
Fish known as old wives lurk amongst the weeds, alongside predatory snook. The red-lipped morwong is another handsome fish that enjoys good coverage. And let's not forget our friend, the wrasse.
Under and around the rocky ledges is home to fish such as banded sweep and gold-spotted sweetlips, sand bass and dense schools of rough bullseye. Also, the very attractive and very venomous lionfish. Tucked away in the nooks and crannies are the highly prized western rock lobster.
Large schools of thick-bodied fish are frequently encountered. They are the silver drummer, or buff brim, a vegetarian fish renowned for their poor eating qualities. Wildlife abounds about Shoal Water. This cormorant demonstrates its impressive swimming and fishing skills. It would be an unlucky visitor who missed out on seeing a dolphin. It's not out of the ordinary to see pods of these mammals together with sea lions. This particular fella is obviously quite familiar with boats and no stranger to the prospect of a scrumptious fishy morsel. A terrible example is being set here. For the protection of the animals, they should not be encouraged.
So that's Shoalwater Bay. It's great.